After Jacob Nielsen's keynote at our in-person UX conference, an attendee asked him about the UX impact of the metaverse and three-dimensional user interfaces.
Well, I think there are two different aspects of that. And the first one relates to the methodologies. And for that, I think they are basically the same, which is you make prototypes. It's harder to make the simple prototypes and those kind of more fancy technologies, but in principle, still the same. Make some rough virtual worlds first, get some feedback from users, have them do some real tasks. I think that's the main weakness right now. A lot of this is based on demos, not based on people trying to actually accomplish or achieve something. And I feel like a very large number of the designs that we're seeing right now are pretty close to useless, and they get out anyway because they haven't been confronted with people trying to actually do something that they want to do, something useful. So that methodology is really the same recommendations as ever. Then the second thing is, what are the useful tasks? What are the things that these technologies are useful for? I tend to believe that they are useful for less than some of the hype. I mean, maybe I'm wrong. It's hard to say because we have to see those useful things to actually find out. But I feel like there's a very large number of things for which two dimensions are actually better than three dimensions. A lot of kind of more data-oriented type of things. And then there are other things, certainly a lot of games and entertainment, but also a lot of things related to the physical world, whether it's any kind of manufacturing or repairs or maintenance of engines or things, basically. A lot of medical things, because of course you're planning the surgery on a 3D, you know, heart or whatever they're operating on. So I think there's a very large number of applications for which it can be very, very useful. I just feel like we're not seeing so many of those. In the demos tend to be very superficial and based on things that have a bit of novelty effect, but not something I think people will in the long run really prefer. But I feel like it has a lot. I think those metaverse ideas have a lot of potential, but I also feel like they're being completely overhyped right now. So I can sort of think both of those two things simultaneously. I don't think it's worthless, but I also don't think it's going to be the only main thing that's going to take over everything.